Alex, how's the preparations going ahead of the game?
Preparation is good. We've had a decent week training. Boys have worked hard again. Looking forward to the game.
Great result against Dundee United. Massive win, much needed. Did the win maybe come at the right time, but yet the wrong time with the sake of the international break coming along for momentum?
Nah, not really. I think, we knew what the script was. We knew there was a break coming up. You know, we've been trying hard to get a result, and it's just not been that way. So, you know, to get it at that time is good. You know, the boys can go off now, and you know, they went off and had a nice couple of days off. You know, and then we had a period of training where we can get some work done into them. So, and they trained well. They're on a high. You know, we just want to try and go up there now and keep that going. You know, work hard and try and get a result up there.
One of the things that we've been talking about quite a lot post-match on Kelly TV is the performances, which was outstanding against Dundee United. But bar maybe, as you said as well, the second half against Rangers,
yes,
there's not been a bad performance. Just not had those little breaks, have we?
So? No, that's right. I mean, the dads, I keep saying, I do repeat myself, but I do say that they have worked hard. You know, they trained well. In the games, they've been excellent. You know, apart from, like you said, the second half of Rangers, I thought we let ourselves down collectively. But since that, you know, they came back against Dundee and were very good. You know, we got the goals at the right time. You know, I could relax a little bit on the side and give people some game time as well. So there's competition for places. You know, everyone's working hard again this week, and we're looking forward to going up to Aberdeen and try and get a result.
It was well documented that you changed the system for the Dundee United game, and it paid dividends, clearly having Nicky Kabamba and Eamon Brophy playing up together. Does that give you a good selection headache going ahead to the game?
Yeah, it does. You know what I mean? I have to pick the sides to who we get play against sometimes. You know, I want to get my best players out there, the ones who are in form on the pitch. But at the same time, I have to think about the bigger picture. You know, we want to go there and we want to work hard and be solid. But we'll see, come Saturday, you know. I'm still debating over that one.
It's been kind of start-stop for Aberdeen. That's also been pretty well documented as to what happened there. Does that hinder our preparation for the game? Obviously, analysing what they do, looking at what they do, or have we have a good chance to look at them? We know what they're all about, though.
Yeah, I mean, Andy's watched them a few times. I've watched them. You know, we watch videos. We know what they're about. They're a good side. You know, got an experience and a good manager who gets the best out of his teams. You know, they're always hard to beat, you know. So, like I said, we're looking forward to it. It's more about us going up there and putting in a performance and, like I say, try and get a result.
I think it's been, the record against Aberdeen's not been, it's been a bit of a bogey team for
yes.
us over the last few years. Clearly we want to try and change that. You remember back maybe to 2018, Greg Stewart and Eamon Brophy, that free kick as well.
Yes.
So trying to recapture that this weekend with what we've got available is clearly what we want to do.
Of course, you know, I mean, I was there at the club when we went up there and won. And we've had a few draws since that, you know. It's going to be tough. We know that. They're in a good form as well, you know, since they've came back after the lockdown. You know, they've won some good games. They've been and won at Hibs, and I was at the game, and they were solid and aggressive. You know what Aberdeen do, and you know, and we got to match that if we want to get anything out of the game. We got to be as good as them, if not better, and go there and try and win the game.
They're quite a robust team defensively. We've got tools at our disposal that could really get in behind them as well. That's going to be one of the big key things, is how we keep their defence at bay at the weekend.
Of course, we have to, you know, be on the front foot. We have to go for it. We can't be timid. You know what I mean? We have to be, you know, we have to go there with the right attitude. You know, like I said earlier, we have to match them. Yeah, and then some, you know, and once we can get hold of the ball and start playing, you know, I'm sure we can cause them problems. But we know it's going to be a tough game, you know. And I've tried to prepare the team this week to know that, you know, they're up there. It's going to be a tough outfit. You know, it's going to be a tough afternoon, but we can go there and we feel we can go there and get a result. The boys are in a good spirit at the moment.
Fingers crossed we can keep the momentum going with that. There'll be fans back in the stadium at the weekend, only a smattering 300 fans in, but that's a step in the right direction, and hopefully back here at Rugby Park we can have fans in pretty soon as well.
Yeah, I hope so. I mean, it's I know it's 300 Aberdeen fans, but that's okay. You know what I mean? The most important thing in the big picture is that we get supporters back in, you know, because the clubs, they need it. The supporters need it. They need a release from their daily lives to get back into clubs. And it's so important. It's very important that we start looking forward to getting back to some normality, you know what I mean? And it's a step, you know? And our boys are professional. It doesn't matter whether it's 300 Aberdeen fans or 300 Kilmarnock fans. We just want to be, you know, playing in front of people and enjoy what we do.
Have we kind of switched off to the fact that there's no fans in stadiums now? I mean, it's clearly weird and it is very strange running out with the music played, but nobody's really there. And is that kind of, the boys put that and yourself put that to the back?
Yeah, of course, now? We don't speak about it anymore. You know what I mean? We know what it is. We just get on with it. You go out there and you have to be a professional and go and play. Obviously, everyone wants supporters back in because it gives you that little bit of extra percentage. You know what I mean? But at the same time, it is what it is, and we have to get on with it, you know? And that's why you're a professional. You got that title because you can handle these situations. And I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a good game.
And finally, just on Stuart Finlay and Alan Power, are you in a position to give us an update with those guys?
Stuart Finlay's started training. So we'll see how he's over the next couple of days. And now he's reacted to the training. But Alan Powell's a no, definitely a no. He might be 10 days still away or 2 weeks. So we have to wait and see on that one. But Finley's got a good chance of playing, yeah.